When we think of attention, we mostly think of someone sitting in a classroom listening to a teacher give a lecture. That is a form of attention. But attention is the thing that really precipitates how our brains formulate and break down daily tasks. A task is simply a process, something that the brain does. It can also be something that you intentionally do. Tasks are managed by two components of the brain, the default mode network and the task positive network. The default mode network is how our brains usually are when we're at rest. We're thinking about different things, we're remembering different things, we're vibing, you know? Talking to our friends, remembering past conversations and feelings. The biggest component of the DMN is the hippocampus, so it has to do with memory and learning. When we start to do a voluntary task, we switch to the task positive network. When we switch to the task positive network, the default mode network is supposed to shut off. This is the voluntary routing from our parietal lobe to our muscles to our medial prefrontal cortex that allow us to think of something and then execute it. When you get to people like me who have ADHD, this process gets interrupted. Our default mode network does not shut off. It runs at the same time as the task positive network, which draws our focus and attention away from completing the tasks in front of us. This is also why we can get into hyperfixation. Of interest to note, because the hippocampus plays a role in the default mode network, we must also look at the overlap between ADHD and PTSD. Because if your default mode network never shuts off, you are more likely to be plagued by intrusive thoughts and traumatic memories. If your default mode network is saturated with traumatic recall, that makes it even less likely that you switch to the task positive network. This also has an overlap with our impairments in declarative recall and the impairment of working memory in those with ADHD. Another overlap is the personality disorder ASPD, or antisocial personality disorder, which also shows deficits in the medial prefrontal cortex and also displays similar dopamine inhibition. This is where you get chronic boredom. Being aware of these structural differences in the brain can help you to plan tasks more effectively if you share these disorders.